As JP has been showing us right now, Idalia could bring up to 4 feet of storm surge to southwest Florida's coast. Thanks so much for watching ABC 7 for our extended coverage of Tropical Storm Idalia. I'm Megan Miller.
And I'm Jeff Harris. More than 10 feet of Hurricane Ian's storm surge nearly covered the entire island of Fort Myers Beach. Rushing waters can travel miles inland from the Gulf of Mexico. ABC 7's Gage Goulding is joining us live from Times Square tonight, and he's showing us what different levels of storm surge would look like there. Hey, Gage.
Yeah, hey, Jeff, Megan, I want to make one thing very clear. This is not Hurricane Ian. We're not going to see anywhere even close to Hurricane Ian level storm surge, but we are going to see some storm surge right here in Lee County where we're at in Times Square on Fort Myers Beach. We could see 2 to 4 inches on the higher end. This is only if kind of there's this perfect concoction, right? The peak high tide, which is around 2:20, 2:30 a.m. on Wednesday morning, right? So not this upcoming morning, but the next morning after that, when we're all hopefully fast asleep. And then also there's the peak storm surge time, which is kind of after midnight into the early morning hours of Wednesdays when we could see that most storm surge. So unfortunately, it kind of looks like it's aiming up to be that concoction. And you're probably wondering, Gage, why are you standing out here in the middle of the Gulf of Mexico? Well, it's because I want to show you what that 2 to 4 feet of storm surge will look like. As I kind of back up a little bit further into the water here, this pool in my hand is 8 feet long. We're not going to see that, all right? But it is a good way to kind of show where I'm standing right now, I'd say, is 3 feet coming to about 4 feet where I'm at right now. So if we put that 4 feet underwater, right, and this is approximate, so just work with me here. 4 feet underwater, where we would be at tomorrow, approximately, worst case scenario is what we're talking about right here, would be towards the top of this pool where that little yellow reflective tape is that we put on there for you. So me, I would be underwater. I would be trying to swim. Now, just like these waves are coming in and pushing me around right now, the swells, that kind of adds a little bit more to it, right? Okay, so Gage, you're standing out in the middle of the Gulf of Mexico. What does this mean for me? Of course, there's going to be water in the ocean at high tide. Great question. So the best way to kind of show this, once again, using this pool, we're not going to see 8 feet where there's dry land, not even close to that. Worst case scenario, 4 feet. Let's use this old beaten up part of the Fort Myers Beach Pier, right? Here's 8 feet approximately. So worst case scenario of what we'll be seeing is around 4 feet. I'd say that's about around here. Now, this is kind of west of the rack line, which is where the high tide comes in. So we could see a little bit more, but give you an example. I'm 6'3". I promise I'm 6'3". Water would be about belly button high for me. So obviously not a place you'd want to be during the storm. Now, another big question is, all right, I don't plan on venturing out near the pier. I don't plan on venturing out in the Gulf. Probably two really good ideas for tomorrow, but what about Times Square? What about Fort Myers Beach? What about my home? What could that look like? Well, coming up in just under 30 minutes here on ABC 7, I'm going to give you a look and kind of another comparison, a live example of what that water will look like in Times Square and some of our businesses maybe out on the street on Fort Myers Beach. So another kind of visualization for you coming up in just about 30 minutes right here on ABC 7. I'm reporting live on Fort Myers Beach. Gage Goulding, ABC 7.